supported by her husband, Dean Hine.
Myself, and of course, Natalie and Clint, we want to thank everybody for coming. I know a lot of you have come a long ways. We're here to celebrate a new beginning, and I expect them to be married as long as their parents have, which is probably 39 years. So I hope everybody has a good time. As I said again, we appreciate everybody coming. Thank you.
I'm Alex Clint's best man, best friend. We've been friends since I can remember. We played football together. We coached we managed the pool, the Macon swimming pool. We did that for 3 or 4 years. We've learned a lot about each other. And throughout that time, I've learned a lot about Clint's strengths and weaknesses. And during that time, Clint has asked me, what do you look for in a woman? And, you know, that's a pretty broad topic, but what I came up with is Clint has to find someone that's willing to put up with his crap. Clint has many interests. Video games. He likes fitness. He likes sports. He likes a bunch of different topics. And he has to find a woman who's willing to not only, be interested in those topics along with him, but also engage them and keep him interested in other things. And I think he found a perfect person in Natalie. I know Natalie. We had a class at Truman called Sex Class. It's not as fun as you might think. It was actually about breastfeeding, which she found very interesting and involved in the field in that. And I did not find it as interesting. I may or may not have cheated off her on some of the quizzes. But in those classes, I've learned that Natalie has a good heart. And as I got to know both she and Clint, as I've got to know both of them together, I've seen that she thrives off of Clint's intensity and passion about what he's doing, whether it be biking or coaching. She's all in on whatever he's doing, and that's something that you look for in a mate. And I think if you just look at these two and see the love that they share and see that the passion they have for each other, you know that they're going to last for a long time. So, Clint, Natalie, I love you both. Natalie, you look beautiful, and I probably speak for all of us when we say we're ready for some kids to be coming up this way.
It'll be your best man, everybody. This time we'd like to invite your maid of honor, Adrian Schubach, to say a few words for the bride and groom.
So I apologize. I'm definitely not the speaker that the best man is here. So I would say good evening. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Adrian. I'm the very proud big sister of our beautiful bride. I want to start by thanking you all for coming tonight and also congratulating the bride and groom. So, being only 18 months apart in age, Natalie and I pretty much were inseparable growing up. As you can see, when we were little, it meant always having a best friend to play Barbies with. Somehow, despite innumerable fights in the bathroom about sharing ready. Also, so many fights about wearing each other's clothes without asking. We remained very close friends in junior high, our awkward days, and also high school. We spent so much time playing basketball together in our driveway. I must admit, a few times, it definitely ended with us whipping the ball at each other because we were angry. But more often than not, it ended with us both bent over at the knees, laughing uncontrollably because something hilarious happened, and neither of us could pull it together to get ready for the next play. Although college separated us by quite a bit of distance, we remained very close friends. And I think a lot of you didn't realize that Natalie actually spent 5 years in college. The first was spent her senior year of high school visiting me every single other weekend at U of I. We had a lot of really good times then. Of course, also, it's only natural that somehow we both got engaged only 2 months apart and got to plan our weddings together. Natalie has truly given the word sister true meaning. Over the nearly 30 years I've spent with my sister and best friend, there have been so many experiences together that have shown me the truly incredible person that she is. It is these same key qualities that have always amazed me that will no doubt make her an incredible wife. Even as a little girl, it was amazing how truly giving of a person Natalie was. I remember one particular Christmas that really displayed this. I think we must have been about 6 or 7 years old. My very favorite toy at this time was a silver plastic guitar. In about September, that guitar went missing. I searched our entire house. I looked everywhere for that guitar and couldn't find it anywhere. That was until Christmas morning when I opened up my present from Natalie to find my guitar. I was so mad at her, but I was thrilled to have it back. She said that she knew I loved it so much she wanted to give it to me as a present. I kind of understood her logic, but really thought my present really kind of stunk. That was until our older brother, Skylar, opened up his present. As he tore off the newspaper wrapping Christmas paper, he found this gross, rotten mush that oozed all over him. It was then clear that her present to him had been a delicious apple that she had wrapped up way back in October. What a sweet little girl trying to give her siblings such a cute gift. Natalie has also been one of the most forgiving people that I've ever met. I still remember one example so clearly. We were nearing the end of the bus route one night with only a few kids left on board. We were sitting together in our assigned seat near the back of the bus. We got into a heated argument about who knows what. Being the 10-year-old brat that I was, my temper got the best of me and I punched her right in the face. We were less than a mile from our house and her nose was gushing blood. I frantically started begging and pleading with her, please don't tell, please don't tell. For some crazy reason, she took pity on me. As she walked off the bus, she walked with her head down and held her backpack in front of her face so that our bus driver, Sharon, couldn't see her bloody nose. What an amazing, forgiving person. What kind of kid would forgive their older sibling who, seconds before, punched them right in the face, giving them a bloody nose? Now that was forgiveness. Natalie is also one of the most loving and caring people on this earth. What better career for her to dedicate her life to than nursing? I realized how incredibly loving and caring my sister was my last year of medical school. In the midst of residency interviews, I fractured my femur and pelvis, leaving me struggling to get around on crutches. She immediately switched her entire work schedule for the month so that she could travel with me to each and every interview that had remaining. We spent that month flying and driving all over the country. These were very far from enjoyable trips for Natalie. Her time was spent wheeling me around, lugging both of our luggage, listening to me whining, waking up at the crack of dawn to help me bathe and get dressed, and ironing my suit over and over again. What a truly loving, caring friend to do that for someone. And boy, do I owe her for life. You meet few people in this life as loyal and dependable as Natalie. I think all of her friends would attest to this. I remember one particular family summer vacation in Wisconsin that really illustrated this. Natalie and I were probably in our teens or early 20s. Like every other vacation, we slept on my parents' pull-out sofa in the living room of the hotel. One evening before bed, I made a plan with our sister-in-law, Mary Ellen, to go running bright and early. I awoke from a deep sleep to hear a knocking at the door. I hurried clumsily over, not having a chance to put on my glasses, and swung open the door. I blinked and squinted for a few seconds before making out that it was definitely not our sister-in-law standing there, but some strange man. I blinked and squinted a few seconds more and realized it was not one of our brothers, like I assumed, but some strange 20-something-year-old man standing there in only his whitey tighties. In an instant, he was stumbling and mumbling forward into our room, clearly intoxicated. I urgently pleaded with him, "You have the wrong room. This isn't your room." But he didn't listen. He continued to come in, so I resorted to the, "My dad is 6'4" and sleeping right there. If he comes out and finds you here, he will kill you." But it had no effect. Just at that moment, I saw Natalie's head pop up from our bed, and she asked, "Adrian?" I quickly responded in a panicked voice of, "Get him out!" In 0.2 seconds, Natalie was up out of bed, barreling across the room, and with her shoulder lowered, nailed the guy like a linebacker, sending him flying backward, bouncing off the open door and into a pile on the floor outside in the hallway. We quickly slammed the door, deadbolted it, and spent the next 5 minutes taking turns looking out the peephole, laughing at this poor guy laying there in his underwear moaning. It then became clear that there had been a wedding that night at the hotel, and this guy apparently had a little too much fun. I hope you all have fun tonight, but hope that none of you guys end up like this poor guy getting beat up by a girl. We laid back in bed and tried to go to sleep, but we couldn't stop laughing about what happened. I realized then that Natalie was such a loyal person. With just a 3-word command, the guy was out of our room. But seriously, these stories highlight the incredible qualities that Natalie has always displayed that I will forever admire. She is giving, caring and loving, loyal and forgiving. I didn't know how she would ever find someone to match up to all that until she found Clint. When I look at Natalie and Clint, I feel so much happiness and excitement for them. I know that Natalie has found her true match. He not only shares all these same amazing qualities, he is kind and giving, loving, loyal, and forgiving. He also brings a great sense of humor. He is absolutely hilarious. He constantly smiling and fills everyone around him with so much laughter. His laid-back nature has also allowed him to survive multiple Schubach family vacations, despite getting blamed for breaking every single piece of junk jet ski that has ever broke down, so he does get blamed for it. They both hold the key ingredients, giving, forgiving, love, and loyalty. These combined with a good sense of humor to share a laugh together in the midst of difficult times will no doubt lead to a long-lasting marriage filled with so much happiness and love. Separately, you two are special, remarkable people, but together you are complete. I know that you will have a long and wonderful adventure ahead of you, and I am so blessed to be able to watch alongside you. I love you both so much. Please raise your glasses while I toast my sister and new brother-in-law. To Natalie and Clint, may you have continued loving friendship, enjoy tremendous success, and be blessed with many Baldwin babies. May you share so much laughter, experience unlimited happiness, and may all your dreams come true over your lifetime together. May your love for each other continue to deepen and grow each and every day throughout the many years ahead of you. Cheers.
Good maid of honor, everybody.
You're my so tight. Close your eyes and say a prayer that I kiss your hand goodnight. As we dance, I keep our love deep within my heart. Thank God for giving me the same to live in my arms. You're my little angel, so baby, don't you cry. It's time to spread the wings and fly. If there's one thing this father knows, the hardest part is letting go. You will always be daddy's little angel. Father knows,
That's what I'm talking about. Which side is that guy at? Shoebox or Baldwin? Shoebox, oh man.